Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. Today we are diving into Microsoft To-Do. We're going to be exploring the iOS application, talking a little bit about the web version, Android version and Windows version to go into a bit more detail from the last video I did about Microsoft To-Do. So as you can imagine, Microsoft To-Do is an application that's capturing a lot of people's attention. It's growing in popularity in terms of how many features they're adding and the additions they're actually fixing in the application, which is super positive. If you do want to see what's new with Microsoft To-Do, feel free to check out the video in the cards above. So here we are with the iOS version. I want to give you a tour around this application. The additions aren't that dissimilar. So you have your first page, you have My Day. And My Day is essentially an area for you to start organizing what you're going to be doing today. It's essentially your Today section, very similar to Todoist. So if you go in that top right-hand corner, you can see at the top of the page, you've got My Day, Important, Planned, and Tasks. And these are like almost your pinned sidebars, so you can see all of the most important things. So My Day starts basically with the ability to add tasks to this list. So for example, from here, I could add maybe buy milk, because I actually need to do that, play some basketball. And you can see once I add all of these, they're going into what's called my tasks list. And I can go over to the task list and actually find them at the bottom. Now, if I at any given point wanted to, for example, let's say went into Watch Venom, click Add to My Day, and it will automatically go into the My Day section. So with every single task, no matter whether it's in a project or a list, or whether it's inside of task area, you can do that to any task that isn't already associated to My Day, which is quite helpful. So being able to add a task is quite easy. Of course, I just put buy milk there, but you can add steps below them if you really wanted to, if there's more steps into it than just buying milk. You can remove it here from My Day too, but you can also add it back again. And you may notice a star next to the buy milk at the top, and that's to add it to the important list. So if I go back out, obviously you can see it in that important list there, and it makes it a little bit easier to access. So once I'm in My Day, that will also be starred as important. So when you're trying to differentiate what tasks are important and what are not, you can see that by the side. Now there's also Remind Me. So you can click Remind Me and turn on notifications. Now if you haven't done that yet, you can see that on the iOS device pops up, allowing you a nudge there. And you can specifically choose a time and a date. So for example, if actually I do need to do that at about 10:15-ish. So you can be very specific about when you want to be reminded. Now, something to note as well, you don't have the ability to add multiple reminders, but I don't think that's really going to be too much of a bother for you. Now, you can add what's called a due date. So for example, if I'm like, okay, I really need to get it by tomorrow, then you can add a due date. So essentially, you've got, by adding it to My Day, you've essentially got start date or an actual due date. And then you've got a due date, which allows you to get a sort of deadline on the task. Now, you do have the ability to repeat, and you can do that. You can also custom repeat it. So you've also got daily to yearly here, but you've also got the ability to have a custom one. So, for example, if you want every 6 days, something very specific, you can. I know a lot of people like the iconography as well of this application. Now, here you can also add a file. So for example, you can add it through iOS, through photo library, camera, or files. So if you want to attach something, it's really easy. If you've already got a files, iCloud file set up, then you can import it automatically and you can add as many as you like too. So that's great news. You can add as many as I don't think they have a limit. I think it may be even 25 megabytes per task, which isn't too bad, I don't think. You've also got the ability to add a note as well, which is just really, really simple. And down at the bottom right-hand corner there, you can see you can delete tasks too. So that's really all in all what the inside of a task looks like, being able to add context. Now, the great thing as well is you have the ability to multi-select. So for example, I went to top right-hand corner and I pressed edit and I wanted to highlight maybe the play basketball or watch Venom. You can move that, you can change the due date, or you can move it to a specific a tasks area, personal list, etc. So you can move multiple of them, and you can even select all at any given time. You can change the due date on them. So obviously they will stay in today, but you can change the actual due date of the task. You can also move them around too if you're really eager to. Now, up in the top right-hand corner, you do have the ability to sort based on importance. So if you wanted to organize that quickly, just based on which ones are starred or not, you can do that, and you can have it by descending or ascending order. And you can also sort by alphabetical, due date, creation date, and whether they're completed so far. And you can clear that any given time, and it will return to its original status. Now, if you've completed a task, so for example, we watched Venom the other day, and of course it still retains in, so if I go back in, it still was there. So one thing you can do is click hide completed tasks, and of course that will disappear. If you want to see show completed tasks, you can. I know a lot of people do actually like to see it because they want to know whether they've done that in the day. Now, one of the final things and something you can do inside of all lists is customizing each of your folders or your lists. And that's just by changing the header color. So you can actually see different colors here, 5 primary colors. I like the dark blue. You can also change the background too. So whether you just want a city or a plane going up or even a lovely beach. But in this case, I might choose this lovely home one. But you can have it plain if that's something that you just want to keep pretty simple. Once you click done, obviously that's your My Day area. And one of the nice exciting things as well is in the top right-hand corner, you can click this area called Suggestions. And suggestions are available through all of the editions of Microsoft To Do. And essentially what you can do is you can look at your overdue and suggested tasks. So for example, you can see here that I've got an overdue run 5 kilometers, and maybe I do want to do that today. Now it's already embedded by the looks of it in my tasks area with a due date of Wednesday the 13th of February. Now if I wanted to add it to my day area, all I have to do is press the plus and you can see it pops up added to my day and it will disappear. Now it's the same with projects. So for example, it will take out some of the tasks from the areas that you've got. So for example, look, I've got work, personal tasks, or these are all different lists. So I maybe need to organize Amsterdam trip. So I'm going to click tick that one. I don't need to feed the cat. So I'm going to mark that as complete. So you can do that from there or delete the task. I'm not actually needing to order the table. I don't need to wash the car. And I don't need to upload articles yet. So all I'm after going to do is go to done in the top right hand corner. Now you can see here that the run 5K has been added and I can go back in and actually change the due date for that, maybe till this Thursday, and I go back. And the same with the organize the Amsterdam trip. So you can see all of the details being transferred and you can see some of the examples of subtasks here and you can tick them off as you go. So if I go back out to my day, you can see 2 out of 3 of those tasks are done. And that's essentially all of the my day area. It's one of the features that I think actually people do quite enjoy. Now, once you've explained my day, you don't really have to explain the important area. You've got areas where you can star tasks, which is really easy to do. And if you go back, you can also see what tasks you have coming up. So you can see, okay, I'm going to minimize today. But okay, between Wednesday and Sunday, although they're in my day, you know, they've actually got a due date of that and also ones that are even later. So you can click in and if I change that, for example, if I put it as tomorrow and went back, you could probably see it in its own different area called tomorrow. So this is quite a nice view if you're looking to see basically your next 7 days. Now the tasks area is literally for any of your tasks that don't necessarily have a project list. And it's almost just like a general list. So for example, if you wanted to, you could utilize the sorting features and you can even choose the ones that have been added to My Day. So all of the My Day ones will come up in here. You can even sort them, you know, both ascending and descending. And you can also go and set them by the alphabet. That's what I was going to do. That's quite a handy one. I know people like that too. You can customize this theme as well if you want to with those 5 primary colors. And that can help you get started. Now, just to go over the different lists you've created. So, for example, you can see I've got personal and I've taken my passport photo there. I haven't ordered a new table. It's very similar. All you have to do is go to create new list and they'll prompt you to add a title to that. Now, if I clear all of this and maybe put, project A, you can, if you want to, add an emoji to the start of that. So, for example, actually, I'm going to change this one to, places to visit, because that could be nice. And then I go up to the top right-hand corner and change that to red because it's nice. And there we go, a nice background with the actual plane in the background. So you can see here that the emoji has been taken as a almost an icon of the project, which I quite like. So you can move that around as well. So for example, if I wanted to move travel to the top, I could quite easily do so. And that's really how to create lists. Lists are really, really easy to get on with. The real magic inside of lists is the sharing ability. So you may see in the top right-hand corner, I've got sharing set up. And I will explain how to do that right now with this brand new list we have, the places to visit. So if I go to the plus in the top right-hand corner, I can press send invitation link. And essentially that is sent to new members. You can copy it. And once you send it to a new member, they'll get access to that. And they can view it and even modify it with a Microsoft To-Do account. Now you can limit access to current members, so what they actually see inside of there, so you can cancel the link and you can re-access the link and stop sharing it automatically. But that makes it a shareable area, and the sharing icon appears. I'm not sure whether you can see you can tell which ones have been shared, which ones haven't, but you can see here the first two in this case have been shared. So you're probably wondering a few of the minor idiosyncrasies. If I go to the top left-hand corner, I can access my profile. I can have the completion sound, and if you've got the sound on, it sounds fantastic. You can have or choose whether to have those important or planned areas or auto-hide empty smart lists, so that's quite helpful. You can also start importing from Wunderlist from here too. Now, all the other stuff is jargon at the bottom, all the other additional stuff. But for example, let's say I just switched off important and I didn't want that anymore. I could have it back on and it would come back on. So that's something that a lot of people like to do, have their own custom sidebar in this experience. So, of course, the iPad version has three panels, which is something that I know a lot of people like to have, the three different panels, so they can access the sidebar, the tasks list, and then the context of the task. So if we look at the web version, so the web version doesn't have the theme ability that you can access, and also it just seems a little bit lacking in design, but I can imagine over the next couple of weeks they'll definitely be adding to that. You can't add emoji as well. It's sort of like the funness is zapped out of the web version, but I can imagine that's why, because the web version is going to be the least accessed and probably the least important, because a lot of people have Windows. The Windows edition does have a few different things. It's got live tiles. It's also got Cortana as well, so you can connect up with Cortana, which is something that a lot of people like to do. So, for example, seeing your list of tasks coming up. You've also got emoji connected to that one. And what I would say is the Windows edition looks like one of the best. It's also got a dark edition now. Now, Android is the one that has something called snoozed tasks. You can snooze a task for 5 minutes to 1 hour. This is currently in beta, but it's something that I know a lot of people loved inside of an app called Swipes. And it is something that if Microsoft To Do adds, is definitely going to be an exciting application. I did see a lot of people in the comments in the What's New to Microsoft To Do video 2019 do mention that obviously, Google Tasks, why are you comparing to that, Francesco? Yes, Google Tasks is an application that I do compare. It is a lot far behind from Microsoft To Do, but if Google paid even a fraction of attention to it, I think it could quickly catch up with To Do. Now, one other thing I wanted to mention as well is that a lot of people are saying how happy they are with Microsoft To Do and how it's progressing. It's definitely something to consider in 2019. If you would like to watch my downsizing to-do list applications feature, please do check that one out because it might become valuable. Let me know in the comments whether you have any questions. If you would like to become a patron today as well, feel free to follow the link in the description. It'd be great to have you as a supporter of the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Anyway, guys, thanks so much. Do hit subscribe, and I will see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.